Sega.
Today we are at Oxford Brookes University and we're going to be showing some motorsport engineering students a first look at Motorsport Manager on the PC. Coming to Oxford Brookes University just makes sense to us because they have a proven record of getting students into top level motorsport. I believe they have a graduate in every current Formula One team on the grid. These are the guys that are going to judge us the most.
I think you've nailed it for advanced stuff for guys like me. For people who just want to kind of pick it up and play, again, it's quite easy just to skip that step of, you know, setting up the car or optimising it perfectly. You've captured both audiences quite well.
I had the mobile phone app and it's just so much wider and there's so much more you can do with the game itself. Everything's like very accurate.
I mean, the fact you can change quite a lot of setups on the car, you know, the rear wing, the front wing, the stiffness and stuff like that, that's a really good step.
Getting down to the last lap and having the split seconds really dividing the group to what our strategy should be was really exciting, actually.
For sure, they were the most exciting part of the game, yeah. It was getting towards the last few laps and we didn't know whether the car was going to finish or not, but we didn't want to pit because we'd lose position. So, yeah, I think it would have been good to have a heart rate monitor on all of us or something up there.
There's always changing conditions which you can't necessarily change straight away. You've got to wait until the car can pit or potentially push another lap.
If your front wing is starting to get damaged and you're losing seconds and the person behind you is catching up, you think, oh no, should we pit and get some fresh tyres or should we sacrifice a bit of time?
Definitely split second decisions come into it, same as motorsport, so that's part of it and that's captured it quite well.
Today was really important because we want to make a game that's fun to play for casual players, for motorsport fans, but we really need to satisfy the motorsport experts as well. So to be able to come here and show it to students and have them look at it as not just a game, but also a learning tool, and you know they're having fun and debating and really getting into it. But also they're giving us feedback and we're going to take that away and we're going to give it to the developers and make sure that when the game is released in September, it's going to be as good as it can be. The motorsport community is really important to us and that's something that we want to reflect by doing things like today. We don't just want to develop a game and put it out there. We want to make sure that anything we do in the future is going to be steered by not just what we want to do, but what the fans want us to do. If you like this video, make sure you keep up with all the latest from Motorsport Manager by clicking the subscribe button below.